Welcome guys to another video of CS Hobbyist, and in this video I'm going to show you how I made this animation of Harry Potter timeline. You can watch this entire animation on the link given here, so I'm just skipping this animation to the end. So basically this animation consists of three things. First is a photograph of Harry, Ron, all the pictures, snapshots taken from the movie. And then we have some text explaining what's going on, what the event was. And next thing was this entire timeline, which consists of some events and then this long line and in typical timeline style. So let's see how these three basic things made up the animation. So if this is a slide, this is the window you are watching. So that timeline was an image, a very long lengthy image, and what was happening is I was just moving up the image in steps, so it was looking like the events are rolling up, and with that the image and text were also appearing. They were fading out and then moving to the side as the text moved. So let's see a bit in detail how I carried out this animation and how I made up this timeline the way it is. So let's first talk about the animation, as I have already worked it out here on this image. So let's go to animation ribbon and open animation pane. So here you can see this is the entire image. As you can see, compared to the slide, this is a very long image. In fact, the image I used in this animation was quite a big, quite a lengthy one. So here you can see it was so long. So I'll be explaining you on a image which is comparatively of shorter length. So on this image, I applied two animation. Leave this because this one is a fading animation carried from the earlier slide. This animation is nothing but it is a motion path in upward direction. Here it is. So both are motion path in upward direction. The thing is, first one is the motion path starting from the center of the image. Basically, by default, this motion path, the starting point of this motion path for every motion path is the center of the image. So for first motion path, starting point is at the center of the image, and then end point somewhere above it, wherever you want, based on your the timeline event where you want to stop it. Now the second motion path is starting from the end point of first motion path and then ending up somewhere you want based on your events. So this is a trick here. Instead of starting the second animation from the center of the image to the point from the first motion path has ended. So this is how it's working. And about these two images, they are nothing but two animations have been applied. They are a fading effect and then moving to left or right based on their position. And now let me tell you how I created this image. So this image is nothing but a combination of a circle and a line, nothing more than that, and a curve also somewhere wherever it was needed. So to draw a circle, as I told you in my previous tutorials, also double click to get a perfect circle. You can format it with no fill and a border color of whatever you want, and you can increase its weight so it look nice, a ring shaped. Then insert a line starting from this point. You can draw. And thing was, instead of making a rectangle, it might look that these lines were made of rectangle. What I did was that was a bit tricky. As you can see, you cannot make it more than 6 point, and as you would have thought, you might think that you cannot make it thicker than that, but in fact you can. When you click more lines, you can increase the width to like anything. 20 also, maybe 200 also. So it looks like a rectangle, but it's far better than rectangle, because what you can do with it is you don't have to worry about its thickness and all that. And one more thing, this becomes important when you draw a curve, or when you need to draw things that need to have parallel sides. Like for example, you want to draw a pipe. So instead of drawing a rectangle, you can make it by a line, by increasing weight of the line. So that's a bit tricky there. And so like that, I've made a ring and a line. And for making some parallel tracks, I use the curves. You can learn more about how to use these drawing tools in my other tutorials. Again, I'm going to increase this weight to 20 points. And we apply color. So it perfectly merges with the mainstream. Here we go. And can apply color to it. So that it becomes nice, looks even. And back on here. Back on here. And this is how I keep on going and make the entire timeline. And to make it a single image, you can press Ctrl A to select all and right click on it to group them together. So now it becomes an entire image, and you can apply the animation explained here. You can easily do the entire animation. So thanks for watching, and please subscribe the video for more such amazing PowerPoint presentation skills. Thanks for watching.